Program Director, Deputy Chief Justice, Justice Zondo, the Mtiane family, the Chief Justice of our Republic, Chief Justice, Justice Mokgweng Mokgweng, Justice Mbatha, who is with us and spoken to us earlier, the members of the Executive Council of KwaZulu-Natal were with us, the Director General of the province of KwaZulu-Natal, senior officials representing the presidency, as well as the officials from the Department of Justice, the officials from national government, the religious leaders who are with us today, especially Chaplain Kumete and Reverend Ian Boots, distinguished compatriots, good morning to all. As we listen to tribute and the outpouring of love since the breaking of the news of the passing away of the retired Deputy President of the Supreme Court of Appeal, Justice Khayelihle Mtiane, the old Latin legal maxim has been echoing in my head, and that says, let justice be done, though the heavens fall. Indeed, let justice be done, though the heavens may fall, because without justice, we cannot talk about freedom. Freedom, in essence, remains the most cherished goal of all humanity. As we bid farewell to a champion of justice and liberation activist par excellence, we make a solemn vow that justice will be served, though heavens may fall, so that the children of Umzinyathi, Ndwetwe, KwaMashu, Nyanga, Mangaung, KwaNyamazane, and Soweto may grow to taste the fruit of our hard-won freedom. It is these children of our land who, when they feel that their rights are denied and their opportunities squandered, may trust that our courts will be the modern day David who will fight on their behalf and defeat the current day Goliath who stands between them and their dreams of the promised freedom. The demise of this towering legal figure, Justice Mtiane, at a time when our country desperately needs it, legal patriot, can strike fear despite the fact that heavens were probable kind enough to call him at the sunset of his years. To come to term with the loss so colossal and a wound so gaping, the idea of a trumpet of the blind Lady Justice may play on, and this brings the words of comfort echoed by the American Justice Judge Len Hand, where he posited and said, liberty lies in the heart of a man and a woman. When it dies there, no constitution, no law, no court can save it, close quote. Justice Hand goes on to assert that the spirit of liberty is the spirit which is not too sure that it is right. The spirit of liberty is the spirit which seeks to understand the mind of other men and women. The spirit of liberty is the spirit which weighs their interest along its own without bias. As we say farewell, fare thy well, Luvuno, Nguni, we make the promise that the flame of justice and the promise of freedom will not be extinguished in our heart as long as there is a single citizen of our country who goes to bed on an empty stomach. We will become agents of justice ourselves to ensure that no child of the poor is denied access to education or adequate health. We will be ambassadors of justice, and we will ensure that our grandmothers do not struggle to get water, and that our daughters and sisters are safe in every corner of our beautiful land. We will ensure that the African National Congress, which Justice Mtiane passionately defended and defended its cadres during the time of the struggle, remains the embodiment of the values of our society, as it on its own has said that, as I quote, if there were to be a single measure of civilization of the National Democratic Revolution, it would be how it treats the most vulnerable in the society, close quote. Long after we have interned, his mortal remain on our rich soil, we will hasten to compose an epic song to celebrate Ndwedwe, Umzinyathi, Ketshomena, and our province. A song reminds us that not far away from here, our ancestors blessed us with a special son, Ukhayelihle, who, after mastering the law and the way of our captures, wanted our country to be a paradise of opportunity and a beautiful home for all her children. It will be a praise song that will make us rejoice in his larger-than-life leadership achievement on the legal bench, where he led with compassion, understanding, and distinction. There is no question that the sudden passing away of former Deputy President of the Supreme Court of Appeal, Justice Mtiane, dealt a huge blow to his family, the legal fraternity, our country, and the province of KwaZulu-Natal, where he was born and brought. Our nation has been dealt a double blow as Justice Mtiane passed just after the demise of his beloved wife, Mrs. Thandiwe Mtiane. And to the family, for that we say we know this is a double blow. May God be with you. Please accept when we say the loss you have suffered is not yours alone. We pray that your fond memories of your departed fathers and mother will give you strength to face challenges of this world. Justice Mtiane's passing has left us poor because he departed with a vast wealth of wisdom and legal knowledge which the country desperately needed. We also wish to convey our gratitude as the government of KwaZulu-Natal to His Excellency President Cyril Ramaphosa for honoring this humble and dedicated legal scholar and practitioner with Category 2 Special Official Funeral. As flags across the country flies at half-mast, we bow our head in collective honor and tribute to this humble legal eagle. As we know today, his was a journey that called for perseverance, resilience, and endurance because it was forever paved with thorny obstacles. But Justice Mtiane went on to excel and to inspire many others. He did well for one simple reason. He loved our people wholeheartedly. In a country that unashamedly enforced a crime against humanity, the apartheid system, he taught the best way to fight this legalized repression, and that way was the very same instrument of law. Above all, he excelled because he had an understanding that his vocation was a call to serve, a call to serve the noble cause on earth, justice and freedom for all. This reminds us of what former President Nelson Mandela said, addressing the Law Society of Transvaal in October 1993, where former President Madiba said, at the time of the worst excesses of apartheid, judges and lawyers, on the whole, remained silent. Judges, magistrates, and prosecutors enforced apartheid laws without protest. Unwarranted sentences were called for and imposed for contravention of statute passed by unholy apartheid, close quote. Madiba went on to call for the transformation of judiciary, to have more black lawyers, more black women jurists on the bench in a future democratic South Africa. In that was the call that Justice Mthiyane responded to later. This he achieved not only through advocating the promotion of black legal practitioners and supporting the advancement of many women, but also through his groundbreaking judgments and the promotion of restorative justice. He was at home with advancing the restorative justice paradigm, because no matter where his character took him in the world, he remained deeply rooted in the African philosophy, the philosophy of Ubuntu, which is underpinned by an idea that umuntu ngumuntu ngabantu, that is, I am because you are, or my humanity is tied with your humanity. From a young age, Justice Mthiyane saw law as a powerful weapon and an instrument to liberate his country and to ensure that all people enjoy equality. In his flight to the top, Justice Mthiyane kept his feet firmly on the ground by selflessly using his newly acquired legal knowledge to advance, and in particular, advance the right as well as the protection of the disadvantaged members of his society. His humble beginning did not make him aloof. His success didn't make him above others. When the eThekwini municipality honored him with a Living Legend Award, he stated that he was doing his job of freeing people through his legal profession without expecting any reward. We take this opportunity to bid farewell to one of those who have made a huge contribution in this country. He has been hailed as a unifying force, a glue that bounded together the judiciary during turbulent times and trials of transformation. For that, we say farewell to Chief Justice Mthiyane. Hamba kahle Zondo Sikhangane. Uyibekile induku ebandla. Nkosi ibe nani, siyabonga.